folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and due to popular demand, as the Oktoberfest music lifts this room into celebration, here's my rig rundown. I get asked all the time here on YouTube, what gear does Dagan use personally? What guitars does he use, amps, effects, all that kind of jazz when he's in his own band? And as you can tell from the festivities in the background, I'm about to play Oktoberfest here in North Shields in the northeast of England. So first off, let's start talking about the guitars, which I use and love dearly. So seeing as this Oktoberfest, first off, cheers. And my main guitar for my entire life at the minute is my Kramer Pacer. Now, as people might know, I love and adore the brand Kramer. I've been a Kramer artist for a little while now, and this is the first one they sent me, the Pacer. But it is awfully modified in the wildest way possible because I just can't help myself taking guitars apart and changing things and all that kind of jazz. So it is the from the factory, maple body, maple neck, beautiful neck. It's a bit worn in and grubby, but you're supposed to play these guitars. I'm getting like an EVH 5150 kind of vibe from it. It's awesome. But the modifications, let's get into them. The first thing I want to talk about is the color and the aesthetics of the Pacer. I'm a big fashion guy. I love boutique fashion and all that kind of stuff. When it was new, this looked awesome, but it's been played a lot in the past 2 and a bit years. It's the colors by Hermes, the fashion company. This one is called Cray. It's a nice cray color, and Cigarro is the brown. It's the color where they do all their handbags and belts and stuff in. I've got the Floyd Rose saddles painted. The Floyd Rose is Cray, the D-Tuner's Cray. I've got the little brass saddles right there. The controls down here, I've got one volume. This is the tone down here, I've moved it to, and this is a coil tap for the neck pickup, which is crackers. I'll talk about that shortly. I also moved the control switch down here because Nuno Betancourt is down there, and I like fiddling with it when it's down there. It's easier than getting down there. The lock and tuners and stuff were painted, but this comes off over time. Got my picks on the head, so I'm gonna talk about the picks more in a second because I use a lot of picks because I've got a habit of throwing them around the crowd and throwing them around me and trying to catch them and failing miserably, so I need lots of picks on me at all times. I painted a stinger on the back of the headstock as well because it's cool, and Eddie Van Halen had a stinger and it looks kind of badass. I also put Goto lock and tuners on as well, which is kind of redundant when you've got a locking nut for the Floyd Rose, but it makes tuning a cinch, and I had them lying around, so I thought, why the devil not? Let's talk about the pickups now, because it's awesome. So the pickups, I've seated them in these lovely little gold surrounds because I'm tacky and I like gold things that shine. The bridge pickup is a Schecter Pasadena Plus. I love the Seymour Duncan JBs that come with these Kramers, but when we visited Schecter and saw their pickup tour, went visited their custom shop and stuff, I checked out the Pasadena pickups, and Schecter makes some awesome, awesome pickups. And this one, as you can see, is not plastic, it's made of wood. It's actually made from a whiskey barrel, an old Whistle Pig whiskey barrel. Those are the bobbins on the bridge pickup. In the neck pickup, I've got a Sustainiac. Now let's plug that in for this, because a Sustainiac is an awesome, awesome little thing, which allows you to hold a note forever, or as long as till the battery dies on the back. So this is what it sounds like as a regular pickup. Sounds awesome, but when you flick this little switch down here, that Oktoberfest music is definitely fitting for this video. That's what a Sustainiac does. It's very fancy and it turns lots and lots of heads. So these two switches here, that turns the Sustainiac on and off, and this switch here is a three-way switch that makes the Sustainiac output a harmonic, a fifth harmonic like you just heard. When it's up position, it just holds the single note that you're playing. When it's in the middle, it's a blend of two. And seeing as you're here, I'll scallop the top four frets of this as well, just because Steve I and Alexi Lejo do it, so I thought I'd do it. It does help kind of grab onto the note and kind of give it a bit of bend when you're up towards the higher register. And it looks pretty badass as well. The back of the guitar is a lot of fun as well. It's got plenty of wall runes. The paint wasn't very thick when I put it on. Well, but I got it put on. So it's nice and properly reliced in. I love the band CKY, they're one of my favorite bands. So I've got a sticker down there, a little succubus sticker down there, because not only is it my girlfriend's Instagram handle, but a succubus is also a demon that takes men back and sleeps with them and then kills them. So I've got that to look forward to. But that covers the hole on the front for the pickup switch right there. There's the battery selector, battery control compartment for the Sustainiac. I extended the hole up here to fit all the circuit boards of the Sustainiac in. A little Star Crawler tattoo up there, like a transferable tattoo, because I love the band Star Crawler. Brass claw, brass L big block in the back, FU tone silent red springs, a little Floyd Rose stop there that I don't use. And that's kind of it for My number one, got the EVH strap. Shallow strap locks, the best strap locks in the biz, in my humble opinion. I've guitar spun this to hell and back, and it hasn't came off yet. Hope that doesn't happen tonight, but yeah, that is my number one Kramer right there. Let's talk about guitar number two, which is my favorite guitar of all time. This is guitar number two. This is my drop D guitar. I could use the drop D on the Kramer, the D tuner, but when I can switch guitars, I switch guitars, and I switch guitars to this, which is my dream guitar, my favorite guitar of all time. I've had it for a few years now. It is a Gibson SG Custom, 2004. This is the guitar that I used to cut out of magazines as a kid and stick on my wall. I managed to get one a few years ago before the prices went absolutely ridiculous. And yeah, this is my baby. Totally stock. It's been changed from a stop tail to this, and then back again, then back to the Maestro Vibrola. Personally, I love the Maestro Vibrola because it looks great, adds a bit of weight to the body, and come on, it's iconic with all this gold. I've disabled the middle pickup, so it kind of just works as a regular SG, so in the middle it's both the middle pickups, and I've dropped this all the way down because it's right in the way of where I pick, and it kept getting in the way, but yeah, it's an SG Custom. I put some Spurzel lock and tuners on it because I like the Spurzel lock and tuners, and the original ones wear it out a little bit. Again, shallow strap locks, the best in the biz, and a Heiser Camp strap. Yeah, being nice and leathery. It's got my initials on the back as well, because I'm tacky and I like things that say my name. It says Just Noise on the back. I bought it just after my granddad died. And my granddad used to say guitar music was just noise. He didn't like rock music at all, so I put the Just Noise sticker on the back as to how much my granddad, who hated guitar music. But yeah, that's my SG Custom. And I love it to bits. This guitar is never going anywhere. This is guitar three, and this is the backup of backups. And when I want to play in standard, this guitar comes in standard tuning sometimes. This is a 2021 Kramer Baretta Custom Graphics Collection Hot Rod. And it's wonderful. So if anything happens to the main Kramer Pacer, the Baretta comes out, because it's got the drop D tuner, it's got the JB in the bridge, and look at it, it's got bloody flames on it, and it sparkles in the light. It's awesome. It's pretty stock. Besides, I put the brass fine tuners on it, because I like the way they look. And on the back, brass block, brass core, girls, girls, girls sticker because Motley Crue. Yeah, pretty much stock. Shallow strap locks again. I rock the same EVH strap. Those are the guitars. Let's talk about my amp and pedal board. So I don't use a cable, I use a wireless system. It's a JLXD Shure Wireless, and it goes in this little box here. I used to have a rack mount thing with a fractal in, going back to using pedals. So this is now on the floor with glow-in-the-dark tape in case my singer stands on it, which he's done a couple of times. Then I go straight into a wah, but it's not a regular wah. This is a bass wah. Bit of drive. I like the bass wah because it sounds like the world's coming to an end. In the middle of the sweep, it sounds like a regular kind of wah. When you get at the higher end, it really gets screechy. And on the low end, you get kind of low, all-encompassing. Plus, it's optical and spring-loaded, so when you stand on it, it turns on, and when you step off it, it turns off, and it always springs back to the upright position. I use that because of Lindy from the band Him. Yeah, that's why. Into a TU2, TU3 tuner. I use a TU2 for all the PMTVUK demos, but this is the next level up, TU3. Look at it tune, there we go. E-flat, the tuning of the people. And then into the limited edition EVH 5150 Phase 90. So the regular one was red stripe. This is the Frankenstrad V1 stripe. It's obviously a phaser. Does what it says on the tin. I've got it in the strip mode, running at, just after 9 o'clock. That's what Eddie had it at. This is the microamp, this is my boost. This is what it says on the tin, it boosts the signal for solos and kind of jazz, but I've got a big old rubber thing that comes with it on the control and a little marker here with some white tape so I can move it with my foot. So when I do leads, it's around about 3 o'clock, but when I want to do lead lines, say while you and singing, I just have it about there and I move it all with my foot. So it's not too loud for a solo, but it's loud enough for lead lines to jump over the rhythm guitar and that's why that's down there. The micro amp, I should say, is in the effects loop of the Amped 1, which I'm going to touch on shortly. Then I go into a Klon, and not a Klon, it's a Serietone Centura, but it is pretty much a Klon. So my main tone is just the Blackstar Amped 1. Depending how fruity I'm feeling, I turn on the Centura. Yeah, and that's that. Then it's going to happen as Tube Streamer, which I use on occasion. That's more when I want to do the Eddie Van Halen thing. I turn the Tube Streamer on instead of the Centura. That's for that. Now I've got an old 70s, late 70s, C3. Can't hear anything's coming through because this music's very loud, but it's very kind of Purple Rain. Boss makes some of the best modulation pedals on the planet. It's awesome. And finally, the other thing that's in the effects loop with the microamp is my Mark II Aquapus delay pedal, and it's just bloody great. Just to prove that it's not a pre-recorded clip, I can't hear what I'm doing, but that's that. And finally, everything goes into the Blackstar Amped 1. So instead of going into an amp, this is what I run into. Sometimes I run into a St. James 6L6, the one I use for the videos. I take that to gigs when the stage is big enough and it looks cool on stage. But besides that, we're into this. This is a 100-watt amplifier in a little box, XLR'd out directly into the desk, into the PA system. Got the monitor mix, got some in-ears. Does what it says on the tin. I've got a set of EL34 UK voice, so it's very Marshall kind of style. Everything's at 1 o'clock on the EQ. Bit of reverb. I have got the preset up as a clean tone. But I never use it. Is that even clean? There we go. I never use it because this is so good at turning the volume down on your guitar. That's my clean tone, just a turned roll down volume. Now, the board itself is the Dodario Expand board. So it's one of the pedal boards that you can make bigger and smaller. And this is now a smaller board for the next two gigs. Usually it's a bit bigger and has these two things on it. This is an old blue MXR 6-band graphic EQ. Same one Dimebag and Eddie Van Halen used to use. I just bought it because of that reason, but I think I'm gonna sell it and buy one of the modern 6-band EQs because this is a little bit noisy. And the Tracy Guns pedal, Tracy Guns signature Spy Sound distortion pedal. This is just a J700 in a box. So I don't want to play old Motley Crue, Guns N' Roses, or LA Guns. This is what goes on into the clean channel of the Blackstar Amped 1. What else are we going to talk about? I've got Dodario cables, pretty much the whole set, XLRs as well, the Dodario Soldiers kit on my board, a little Hercules phone holder so I can see the set list, and when I can't remember chords or songs, I put them on my phone. Tonight we're playing 17 Going Under by Sam Fender, because we are in his hometown, in my hometown of North Shields. So I've got a G7 Capo, and I bought the one that's 18 karat gold, because I'm like a magpie, and I like things that shine, and I'm horrible with my money. Beta 58 microphone, and the Pics, and the strings. Dodario NYXL 10s. I think I'm going to move it to 11s on the SG, because I'm moving it to 10s from 9s on my longer scale length guitars. Pics. Jazz 3. XLs, there we go. 1.14, it's the purple ones you can get, but Dunlop were really nice and gave me ones with my name on in the Gibson font. And the reason I need so many is because I've got a horrible habit of playing guitar these days and throwing them up behind my head like that and trying to catch them and failing miserably. So I need loads on my headstock and loads on my guitar neck here, on my mic stand, because I keep throwing them and then I can never catch them. So that's why I've got lots of picks everywhere. It's not because I drop them, it's because I try and show off. And I feel like I've been showing off through this entire little video, but that is essentially, in a nutshell, while this comedic music is playing, my 2022 guitar rig. Thanks for watching, folks. If you want any information on any of the gear I spoke about in this video, if you want to sound like me for whatever reason, I'll link everything in the description box down below. Give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK here on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. We're playing music today on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok. I'm Dagan Wilkin on Instagram. Yeah, I'll see you next time. Let's play you out. There we go.